Friends, today we are going to start the first clip in the subject Engineering Mathematics 2. In this subject, the first part is analytical geometry. Analytical geometry. Which consists of two chapters. First one is straight lines. And the second is conic sections. Now, I am going to start with the straight line. Straight line. You know what is a straight line? A straight line is a set of points which lie in a straight line. Each passing through a set of points is called, this is called as a straight line. Now, this can be represented by a mathematical equation. Any equation like this, for example, something like this, if I write, this equation represents a straight line. This is called as a linear equation. Here we have two variables, x and y are called variables, means their value is not constant, it can change. So they are called as variables. These numbers 8, 5 and 2, any of them, they are called constants. So in this equation, this is an equation. In this equation, there are three terms, there are two variables and there are three constants. Now, the variables are x and y. The power of x is 1. The power of y is also 1. Any mathematical equation which has two variables, x and y, and their power is 1, is known as a linear equation because it represents a straight line. It can be represented by a straight line. For example, if I give some value to x, I will get another value for y, corresponding value for y. Now, if I plot those points, x and y points, on a graph sheet, I will get a number of points which are collinear, or you can make a straight line to pass through those points. So, this equation is called as a linear equation. Any equation, any mathematical equation having two variables and the power of both the variables is 1 is called as a linear equation, and it represents a straight line on a graph sheet. Now, in general, any equation which is like this, ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. This is the standard equation to a straight line. It represents a straight line and it is called the standard equation of a straight line. Here, x and y again are variables and a, b and c are constants. Now, for example, here in this equation which I have written here, the value of a is 8, the value of B is minus 5 and the value of C is minus 2, because this equation can also be written as 8x minus 5y minus 2 is equal to 0. Now we say that this 2, if I transfer this side and if there is 0 here, then it is called, it is said to be in standard form of equation. So A is 8, B is minus 5 and C is minus 2. These are the values of this. Now, given a straight line, they can ask us to find its slope. What do we mean by slope? See, suppose I have a straight line like this here. This is a straight line drawn on a graph sheet. Now, this line is inclined to the x-axis at some angle theta. The tan of that angle theta is called its slope. It is usually denoted by m. M stands for slope of a straight line. And this straight line, when I plot it on a graph sheet, is inclined to the x-axis by an angle theta, then tan of that theta is called as the slope. So that is the slope. And this length, this is called x-intercept. This length is called x-intercept. And this length from here to here, this is called the y-intercept. Now, given an equation, they can ask me to find out what is the slope. What is the slope of that straight line represented by this straight line, this equation? What is the x-intercept and what is the y-intercept? This type of question can be asked. Now, the answer will be, first you have to recognize what is A, what is B and what is C. You have to find out the values of A, B and C. Then slope M is equal to minus A by B. X intercept, that is how much, what length it cuts on the x-axis, this will be equal to minus A by minus C, or minus A by C. And y-intercept will be equal to minus B by C. So, in this equation, for example, now if this equation is given and we are asked to find its slope, x-intercept and y-intercept, then slope will be equal to minus A, A is 8, divided by B, B is minus 5. So, M will be equal to minus of minus, it becomes plus 8 by 5. This is the slope. If they ask x-intercept, what is the x-intercept? Then it is minus A, A is 8, divided by C, that is minus 2. Now it gets cancelled here. So minus into minus, plus, minus of minus, plus. 2 ones are 2, 2 fours are 8. So it is plus 4. X-intercept is plus 4. What is the y-intercept? Y-intercept will be minus B by C. So minus B is minus 5, C is minus 2. So this will be minus 5 by 2. If it doesn't go, you keep it like that. If it gets cancelled, you cancel it. Otherwise, you keep it as a ratio. Here and here, it doesn't cancel. Here it cancels. 2 ones are 2, 2 fours are 8. So it becomes plus 4. So this is a problem that can be asked. Now,